Ryan Piercy from Coon North America. Today I want to talk to you about our newest series of mower conditioners, the Trailed FC-TLD series. The TLD series comes in three different sizes: the 8'10" worth of cutting width, 2860, the 3160 at 10'2" worth of cutting width, and then the 3560 TLD at 11'6". We're going to talk about some of the unique features on this machine, and that starts up front with the hitch. On these machines you can get two different styles, either the standard 2-point that most people are familiar with, or, like this machine is equipped, the drawbar swivel hitch 2. With this, you can see that we have 3 degrees of articulation, both this way and that way, the gyrodyne when it swings to the left and to the right, and then the pivot pin when it mounts on the mount of the crossbar on your tractor's drawbar that oscillates this way and that way to be able to go over field undulations. To keep maintenance simple, we only have 11 total greaserts on these machines. 5 greaserts are located up in the front PTO section, 5 are on the secondary PTO section, and then 1 greasing point is on the pivot point of the tongue. All 11 greaserts are 50-hour intervals. That means you only need to put in new grease every 50 hours or usually once a week. The TLD series includes the use of the OptiDisc cutter bar. The OptiDisc is our newest cutter bar that includes the ability to be lubed for life. This allows you, the customer, to never need to have routine oil changes. Protected drive safety in case of an impact with an object out in the field. Bolted through protection to give it extra rigidity yet allow it to still be flexible to adapt to uneven field conditions. As well as a low, smooth cut profile. It doesn't allow as much tilt or need as much tilt in the field to keep dust and dirt contamination out, yet get a nice, clean cut of the grass. We also have a feature called Fast Fit that allows you to be able to change the knives out rapidly. To change a knife out with Fast Fit, simply remove the Fast Fit tool located on the right side of the machine, go around to the knife that you wanted to take out. In this case, we're going to simulate this knife on this disc. Align the disc so it is straight up to you and so that the knife and the disc end can go over the hole in the skid shoe. From there, what we're actually going to do is we're going to take the spring that we're going to take and push down on the spring plate with the Fast Fit tool. Simply take the Fast Fit tool, put it underneath the disc in between the disc and the spring plate, push down on it. Then simply take the knife, push down with the knife, pull out. Then you're able to either flip the knife over to utilize the other cutting side or replace it with the new knife. To reinstall is just as simple. Put it over the hole, push down, put the knife in, allow it to make sure it comes up and seats. Release with the Fast Fit tool, take the Fast Fit tool out. As long as the knife can rotate, you're ready to go cut. To adjust your machine to different field conditions and crops, it's pretty straightforward and simple. Once you have the skid shoe selected that you'd like, adjusting your cutting height is done by a turnbuckle on the left-hand side. You can see there's a relative gauge here, but we always recommend to look at the cutter bar. Simply unlock it and turn it. If you want a higher cut height because you want to leave a little more stubble to have less crop contamination and make it easier to rake, simply take it up. Lock down your handle. Then when you have the right skid shoe selected and the right cutting height selected, change your suspension so it makes it so it can keep nice and even following of the ground as you go through the field. To do that, there's a spring on the left and the right hand side. On top of the light shield, there's an access hole to get in and to be able to either lengthen or shorten that spring to make your head heavier or lighter. Like all trailed Coon mowing machines, the TLD has the ability to pick up and back if encountering a field obstacle. This is important because just lifting vertically when mowing through a field and hitting something is not going to help to protect your machine very well. Picking up and back is accomplished very simply. You can see this attaching arm that connects our main frame to our cutter head and the slotted linkage. The slotted linkage also doesn't allow the machine to need hydraulic float, so you don't have to have a hydraulically float-enabled tractor. If I'm mowing through the field and I encounter an immovable obstacle, what'll happen is the cutter head will come up, rise up, and you can see a simple geometry allows it to rise up that slot, and back at the same time, and then reset itself back into mowing position whenever it overcomes it. To effectively condition the crop on the TLDs, we utilize high-strength steel fingers to bring that crop up and impact the conditioning hood. As you can kind of see on the profile of these fingers, it's designed really like a boot. As this spins around, you can see how close we are from the point where the crop gets cut and sent up to where the fingers come around and pick it up and lift it to the hood. In fact, you can see at this point right here, a unique setup on this where the disc is as close as possible to the fingers. To accomplish this, we actually use, in certain locations on the rotor, shorter fingers. Whereas long fingers would get cut up by the knife or start to damage the knife, here we're as close from the knife of the disc to the fingers as possible, so we don't have any excess area for that crop to potentially fall down. As you can see with the fingers, they have a lot of free play. About 80 degrees is what they're allowed to kick back if they come in with a foreign object. Unique to Kuhn mower conditioners is the ability to quickly change your rotor speed without flipping belts. To do that on the TLD, there is a two-handle speed selector on the left-hand side. If you're going from different types of crops, like grass to alfalfa, on the grass setting you may want it fast to be able to get that crop through the machine because it's usually a higher volume. For alfalfa, you may want to slow that rotor down so you're a lot more gentle on those delicate leaves. To do that, you'll see that I have two speeds. Right now, I'm on the rabbit, which is the fast speed. To take it into the turtle, take the handle up and start to move it over. You may have to rotate the disc slightly, allow it to come all the way over, fall in. Now at this speed, when that crop comes off the cutter bar and goes up towards the conditioning hood, those fingers are coming through a little slower, and it's a lot less likely to damage those delicate alfalfa leaves. To fine-tune conditioning intensity, a single point lever on the right-hand side can keep your conditioning hood either farther away or progressively closer to the conditioning fingers. For alfalfa or other delicate legumes, the farthest setting may be what you want to be able to protect the valuable leaves. For grasses, you can take the setting progressively closer. Here, on the bottom setting, that conditioning hood is as close to the rotor as possible. For a real thin stand of grass, you may want to select this to make sure you effectively remove all the cuticle off the stem of the plant. The main gearbox on the left-hand side of the machine provides power not only to the cutter bar, but to the main conditioning rotor, all without the need of belts. Protection for the cutter bar actually comes from the friction slip clutch up in the secondary part of the PTO. To protect the rotor assembly in case of getting a big rock or a large branch and wedging it in between the conditioning rotor and the conditioning hood, what we utilize is shear bolts on the left-hand side of the rotor. Now, what this actually does is, if you get that large branch and it locks up the rotor, the shear bolt will shear. What you can then do is rotate this outer raceway to either this position or this position. Install one of the new shear bolts provided, torque it down, obviously have the obstacle removed, and you're ready to go to the field. In the very unlikely event that you ever shear three different bolts, what you can do is unbolt this assembly, pull it out, it's very easy to take out, unbolt it, remove the excess parts of the shear bolt, put it back together, install it, and install a new shear bolt. It takes about 10 minutes. To set your windrow width, from 3 foot all the way up to 75% of cut width can be done with a single point adjustment. If you want a smaller windrow, simply take the handle closer towards the negative sign. If you want a wider windrow or a wide swath, simply take the handle all the way down towards the positive sign. At this point, this would give us up to 75% of swath coverage. If you have a particular setting that you've become accustomed to and you can't get it from one of these 8 individual settings, you can quickly loosen these bolts and adjust it one way or the other. This makes this infinitely variable. How this actually works is, connected to this handle is the swath board. That takes the crop coming off the conditioning rotor
and directs it up and down the fixed forming sheets. All the way down here in the positive symbol simply takes that crop and sends it straight to the ground, yet just inside the wheels to allow you not to drive on it.
From Broadhead, Wisconsin, we at Coon North America thank you for watching.